just around the corner. It's the Superstars of Wrestling. Welcome, everyone. I'm Vince McMahon, along with two guys who've been filing. And look, they're still smiling. The Hot Rod, Rowdy Roddy Piper, and the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
A perfectly acceptable deduction, McMahon, because the Macho Man has filed and filed on time. Ooh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, aren't you just a little chip off the old H&R Block? I mean, why would you even have a reason to file late? Ever since you met the Warrior at WrestleMania, you've had nothing but time on your hands.
Right off the Macho Man, Piper. Just because my ring career is over, this is tax time. And there are still plenty of people looking forward to the return of the Macho Man. Ooh, yeah!
This week on the Superstars of Wrestling, Paul Bearer's guest in the Funeral Parlour will be the Ultimate Warrior. We'll see action by the new WWF Tag Team Champion, the Nasty Boy. Joining it as well, the Texas Tornado, the Berserker, Bret the Hitman Hart, and more.
The following contest.
All right,
here we go. And this place is going to rock in a moment.
Texas Tornado, bad weather coming down the aisle.
Yeah, you can say that again. The Texas Whirlwind. Carry on, Eric. The Texas Tornado ready to lock horns here.
Hot Rod, you're talking.
Well, he's still over here. You're not supposed to be filling out your... Was that a 1048?
I tell you what, listen, I don't want to be late.
You can't do the short form this year.
Okay, let's talk about Kerry Von Erich, the Texas Tornado. Talk about one of the nicest gentlemen you ever want to meet. Talk about man of war and pure stud and speed. This is it right here.
But remember, Roddy Piper, the nice guys finished last, and Kerry Von Erich is right in battle right now.
Yes. Yes.
All right, guys, you watched the pecs on the Black Knight. Wait a minute, get a good look at those pecs.
I recognize her.
Slinkies.
Oh, Slinkies? Wait a minute.
Look at the pecs on that.
And who is the Black Knight?
Okay. A little guessing game here.
Yep.
All right, Macho Man Randy Savage, you go first.
Okay, I think it's
Pat Patterson.
He retired years ago.
Okay.
Kerry Von Erich just got pushed against the ropes in the Black Knight.
Wait a minute. I'm supposed to be doing the commentary.
That's right, you are.
You were asked a question who the Black Knight was.
And I forgot to give the answer, but I'm right on time now. Lately, here I am.
Yeah, you are on
Thank
time.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
We're not talking taxes, Macho Man. Who do you figure the Black Knight is? I mean, you have fought just about everybody there is.
Andre the Giant.
Oh, please.
It was a guess.
I know the red eye from Japan took its toll, but... That's certainly not Andre the Giant.
Okay, maybe it's not.
Okay. Is it a woman?
Not with a belly like that.
No. But I'll tell you one thing. It's in pain.
Yeah.
It just took a ride, too.
Like it. Indeed.
Kerry Von Erich driving the knee down to the Black Knight, who's going to be a little blacker and maybe a little bluer after this match.
If Ted DiBiase comes running down the aisle, we know it's Sensational Sherry, right?
Wait a minute.
Please don't mention it.
Yes. All right. Downstairs.
Look out. Look out.
And he sets him up off the rope. A spear. Yes.
The discus punch. He's famous for that all around the world.
And a three count.
When I spin, I win, he says.
I like that, Piper. That's only one thing I like about you right there.
Yeah. I hate to break your bubble, but the Texas Tornado said it.
Texas Tornado, Kerry Von Erich, victorious as we take you now to the update.
Update. An inside look from the pages of the World Wrestling Federation magazine. Hi, everyone. Update is brought to you by Coliseum Home Video, the exclusive distributors of WrestleMania 7. The only place you can see the reunification of the Macho Man and Miss Elizabeth. Available right now. Last week on the Superstars of Wrestling, the big earthquake was on his way to the ring
as Jake the Snake Roberts was on his way back to the locker room. These two men passed each other. Let's take a look at what happened.
Jake the Snake, nonetheless victorious, headed back to the dressing room.
Wait a second. You hear that music?
Look. Here's somebody that's not scared of nothing. There is the earthquake. He is big and he's big.
What do you mean he's not afraid of anything?
Now, wait a minute. Right here, Jake the Snake Roberts, he went the wrong way.
I think we're finding out a little bit.
Wait a minute. Earthquake just pulled Jimmy Hart in front of him. Earthquake is deathly afraid of snakes.
He's
afraid of snakes. Look at this.
Unbelievable.
Earthquake pulling 95.
Look at Jimmy Hart.
Jimmy Hart's not scared. Backing up. I've never seen Earthquake back up from anything or anybody. Jake the Snake Roberts had it.
Whoa. Look at that. He threw the guardrail right there.
Earthquake is getting out of here. Jake the Snake is having his fun. And the Earthquake is trying to get out of Dodge. Earthquake, look at the look of terror on his face. This man is not just afraid. He's terrified of snakes. Get him, Jake. Get him.
The Earthquake demonstrating a blatant fear of snakes. Could it be he's suffering from ophidiophobia? Right now, let's hear from Jake the Snake Roberts and the Earthquake, who is standing by with Jimmy Hart.
That snake Damien's dangerous, baby, and you better keep him away from us.
Roberts, last week you thought you were real smart trying to put that snake on me. I'm telling you here and now, keep Damien away from me. I can't stand snakes, but most of all, I can't stand you. I hate your guts.
Are you threatening me? You trying to tell me something? You trying to tell me you're not scared? That you're bad enough to do whatever you want? Are you trying to warn me? Warning me? My mother used to warn me a lot. Don't do those things. Those things that I wasn't supposed to do were always the most fun. For big man, if you want to do something about it, come on down. I serve anybody.
Clear you go.
We're back with more World Wrestling Federation action. By the way, gentlemen, do you know the origin of the word berserk?
Oh, I do. Hot Rod knows. I do.
What is it?
Anybody that dates Sensational Sherry.
He's got a point there. One point for Piper right there.
Macho Man.
One point, but that's not, that's one answer, but there is another answer.
What is it?
The word berserk is a derivative from the term berserker.
I think I'm looking at him right now.
Exactly right. The Berserkers, unquestionably the most feared Scandinavian fighters in history.
Really?
Yeah, as we stated before, they would come at you in full regalia, full armor, but otherwise naked.
Yeah, that's Berserk.
Yeah.
And baby, we got Berserk there with bow legs.
Boy, I'll say we do. Mister, look out. Here we go. With the Berserker going to work on his opponent, Jim Collins.
That would have been a good time to turn around right there.
Boy, we got to start writing these guys notes. Don't turn your back.
Right there. Look at that
now,
guy.
What's this? What's the huss?
Or right now, whether or not we have a huss or whatever, look at this most unusual individual here, the Berserker, just a moment ago ramming his head into the side of his opponent. Off the rope, drop kick by this man. Earlier on, we had an occasion to speak with the Berserker along with his manager, Mr. Fuji. Here's what they had to say.
Huss. Berserker, make Mr. Fuji very proud. You lead us crazy.
I like Mr. Hush. Fuji. You make the pony suffer.
He isn't that dinner for two.
Well, Fuji's got a point right there because suffering builds character. So guess how much character he's giving out right now. Yeah, everybody wrestles him is going to get some character. And look at the Berserker take off now.
And the foot right up there in the mush.
It hurt. Yes.
And Mr. Fuji. Looking on, he certainly...
Was Harvey the Rabbit in there with him?
I don't know about that.
Who's he kicking at?
I don't know, but you can bet that a lot of individuals are not looking forward to meeting the Berserker. Then again, the Earthquake is obviously not looking forward to locking up with Jake the Snake anytime soon, I wouldn't think.
Jake the Snake said, my mother told me that once. With Jake the Snake, you're talking Norman Bates. You never know where he's coming from, and he ain't afraid of nobody.
Yeah, but he's not going to remember what the Earthquake's going to do to him after he does it, Piper. You watch. The Earthquake is a big boy. And look at the Berserker right there.
Yeah,
power slam. Berserker style.
Uh-huh, look at Mr. Fuji. He likes what he sees.
Sure, yes. He's got somebody to make some more money off of right there.
And the Berserker, certainly an individual who follows the instructions of Mr. Fuji to the letter. And unfortunately for this young man, oh no, watch out! Over the top rope, thrown to the outside like so much garbage.
I'll give that name a hold right there and reverse it again. That hold the name, the Berserker hold. I said it right the first time. Thank you.
Vince.
Yeah.
What did he say?
I'm not too sure. Huss, I think.
The Berserker won. Bottom line.
Oh, no, wait a minute. Over the top rope.
Right in the mush.
This man is berserk.
I'm going to tell you, the World Wrestling Federation has changed since I've been in it.
Back to the replay. Hot Rod.
Yeah, it got better. First of all, look at the Berserker. 6'6", 300 pounds. Beautiful jumping right down. That's just a throw down. He don't care. This is an elimination. Look at him squished out much with his hips as he goes around. And there's the face of wonderfulness.
Let's take you now to the event center.
Yeah.
We're back with more World Wrestling Federation action. Oh, yeah. Guess who's making his way to the squared circle, receiving a standing ovation? The Hitman.
Ooh, yeah, the Hitman, Bret Hart. I got a lot of respect for that guy, Piper. I'll tell you right now, he's a great wrestler. What do you think about that?
Well, somebody must have told you that, because you're exactly right. This is one of the finest technicians in the WWF. He's a gentleman, and when you lock up with him, it's like locking up with steel bands.
Not steel bands. I see. The Hitman ready for action. And by the way, ready for action real soon is going to be the immortal and indeed the World Wrestling Federation champion, Hulk Hogan. And what happened to the Hulkster? Can you imagine being victorious, winning the championship, walking back to your dressing room, being interviewed by Gene Okerlund, and then the attack by Sergeant Slaughter?
I call that not expecting the unexpected. You know, he got the belt, and then he kind of let his guard down. Bad sport, Slaughter? Yeah, but he hurt the champion. The champion's hurt.
No, now it's getting to the point. How low can you go? And it's getting disgusting. Slaughter gets low enough, he's going to find himself in trouble.
The Hitman could find himself in trouble when he faces the Barbarian. We spoke to Bret Hart earlier.
Barbarian, go ahead and bring anything you want. Bring your fur, bring your horns. But the bottom line is, you're going to have to out-wrestle me to beat me. And that's not going to happen.
Big words by the Hitman, but the Barbarian's going to put him down.
Maybe.
Maybe. But also, Bret Hart, he's talking about horns. He ain't fighting Rudolph here. Barbarian is a big, tough guy, but Bret Hart's the kind of guy that can last 60 minutes. And I think about the 25-minute mark, the Barbarian will be heaving and a huffing and a puffing.
Well, right now, Barry O is really taking it to the Hitman. Barry O now off the second rope. He'll miss with that.
Hurt that right knee. Right knee's hurt. Barry O's right knee's hurt.
You can bet the Hitman's going to capitalize on this. Solid right hand and another one to the midsection. The Hitman setting over. Look at that.
And you want to check it out. Bret Hart knows when he has a man on the run, and he will not stop. You would have to destroy him to stop him.
One, two. Almost a count of three.
And notice he goes for the pin when he's got a man in trouble. This consummate wrestler.
But what about the Barbarian? Will he be doing the same counter moves that Barry O's doing right now? I don't think so.
Well, good point. Certainly a completely different type of competitor Barbarian would be than Barry O. But then again, that's one of the things that the Hitman excels at, being able to adapt his style to that of his opponent.
Hitman better get a haircut before, he goes against the Barbarian. He might get scalped.
Well, speaking of haircuts, by the way, we'd like to wish well the return of Brutus the Barber Beefcake, who is opening up his own barbershop this weekend.
More guts than brains. Beefcake's not too bright, is he, Piper?
No, Macho Man. Beefcake, you gotta give him credit. He's the kind of guy that don't lay down for nothing.
Right now, Barry O is laying down all right the hard way. Submission hold apply here. Top shooter, what he calls him.
Sharpshooter.
Yeah.
The Hitman's got the sharpshooter on, but can he put it on the Barbarian? Yeah, there's a question for you right there.
I think he can pull that puppy out of the holster in a half a second and have it on the Barbarian. And so do they.
Let's take you back now to the replay and take another look. at Barry O and the Hitman.
Look at the Hitman come running off those ropes. There's a big clothesline. Now, that's a lot of velocity right there. And there's what you're talking about, Vince McMahon. There's the sharpshooter, and he does it better than anyone because he's the only one that does it.
I guess that makes him better, as we take you now to the event center.
All the surrounding areas, just 1 week to go until the World Wrestling Federation returns to the Garden. It all starts next Saturday night at 8 p.m. The main event will feature an explosive encounter, Sergeant Slaughter battling Hulk Hogan. But right now, let's take a look at the incident that has so enraged the Hulkster.
I don't know what you're feeling
for my country, man.
Something, little Hulkamaniacs. Time heals everything. Time heals all wounds. And oh yeah, the Hulkster's mug is starting to look a lot better, brother. But you know something? Time doesn't heal all my little Hulkamaniacs, man. They're still worried about me. They're still worried about how far you'll go, Sergeant Slaughter. Even when I leave Gold's Gym in Venice Beach, California, I ride around now with a WWF title on, just to try to change the train of thought. And whenever I'm going to the grocery store or anywhere else, man, instead of looking at the belt and saying, all right, Hulkster, we're back on top, the only thing they ask me is, Sergeant Slaughter ever gonna burn Hulkamania again? Is Sergeant Slaughter ever gonna scorch the red and yellow of the Hulkster, man? Well, Sergeant Slaughter, now we're into phase two of warfare, brother. I don't know how far you'll go, man. Maybe you'll revert to chemical warfare. Maybe you'll try to burn me from head to toe, man. But I'm ready. I'm ready now to make the ultimate sacrifice, because we're fighting for different reasons, man. I'm fighting for my maniacs, for my family, for God, and for country. And Lord knows what you're fighting for other than ego, power, or greed, brother. So when it all comes down to it, all they're going to remember is if we were good men or bad men. And you're rotten to the core, Slaughter. So what you gonna do when the largest cannons, the Patriots, run wild on you?
As far as Hulk Hogan is concerned, next Saturday night will be payback time for Sergeant Slaughter, the belt on the line at the Boston Garden.
Your taxes come this Monday, but this guy's a little ridiculous, huh?
Too hot to handle, too cold to hold.
Yeah, he's cold, all right. The Undertaker on the cover of the WWF magazine, available this Tuesday.
Wait, the covers are not always that important. It's what's inside. Don't judge a book. RP's inside with some candid remarks of Ted DiBiase.
On his way down, take a look at that. Jimmy Hart. So far, Knobs and Sags, along with Jimmy Hart.
I see Jimmy Hart stole another of Cher's costumes.
What do you mean, the helmet? I've never seen Cher in a helmet before.
No, baby, them tight jeans.
That helmet, however, obviously came in handy at WrestleMania, if you know what I mean.
Why don't we let the past be the past, and why don't we just talk about the present? What do you think about that?
Fine with me. We could talk about the present, talk about the fact that these fellas could have the shortest reign of any tag team championship combination, because hot on their heels, the Legion of Doom.
Roar on a rush. But not for the Nasty Boys, maybe. I don't think they've ever fought anybody like the Legion of Doom before.
You're right, Roddy Piper. Maybe they haven't fought anybody like the LOD before, but you're right for all the wrong reasons.
Huh? Never mind.
Yeah, I guess not. Nonetheless, Jimmy Hart preparing Knobs and Sags for action here in the non-title matchup. To start things off, we're going to have, well, let me see, left for a little conference here. It's going to be Knobs. Knobs against Sataki. Knobs unquestionably an aggressor, much like his tag team partner, and look at Knobs go to work. Series of roundhouse rights, continuing the attack. Very little, well, actually no scientific knowledge thus far displayed by Knobs. Oh, my God, look at that clothesline.
What a clothesline. He's saying we're the best. If you didn't catch it, that's why we're the champions. Now look at the way they talk to each other. Constant communication. That's what we
need. I don't believe I've ever seen that before.
A picture's worth a thousand words. I like it.
Oh, that was nasty. That was very nasty. Nobbs taking a Tachi and smothering his nose in his partner's armpit.
We don't need to talk about it because it's not smell-o-vision.
Oh, thank goodness it's not. They are nasty, and maybe, as Jimmy Hart says, they're as nasty as they want to be. But the Legion of Doom may teach them another lesson about nastiness.
The Legion of Doom can get a little nasty themselves.
Oh! How about that maneuver?
A lot of credibility. I like these guys. They're wearing the belts, and they're very aggressive about it.
That's nothing! Sacks looking back this way. Uh-oh, he's looking back at the Legion of Doom. Gentlemen, we're wondering what's going to happen when you face the Nasty Boys.
What do you think? Nasty Boys are out there calling themselves real nasty. What do we look like, a couple of kindergartners? Not only are we going to beat you up, Nasty Boys, we're going to take the titles.
And the titles will be ours.
About the only things Legion and Doom and Nasty Boys have in common is the same barber.
Well, that's certainly not Brutus. Not in his barber shop. I don't think he would. I don't know. He might let the Legion of Doom in at half price, you know?
If Brutus is smart, he'll get nowhere near the ring when these guys hook up.
What a war. And take a look at this.
Ooh, yeah. That's why they're tag team champions, because they're not afraid of high-risk maneuvers.
Well, that's one of the
There's the Danny Partridge of the WWF.
The Mountain of South, Jimmy Hart, he is content at the moment because he is the manager of the reigning tag team title holders. They're the tag behind the back. Uh-oh.
What are they getting ready to do? They're very creative.
Ooh, down with a big power slam. The legal man now from the top. Sacks.
Look out.
Only one press to go. And up. Ow, the elbow.
On a scale of 1 to 10, what would you call it?
A variation of the Macho Man's elbow, but I'll give it a 9+.
I didn't think it was that good.
High score from a man like you, Randy Savage.
I know the Legion of Doom is listening. You know what I mean?
Victorious once again. Nobbs inside. The reigning tag team title holders. And hot on their trail, the Legion of Doom. Give me a break. You think they're happy to be champions or what? Let's go back to replay, Hot Rod.
Well, you want to check this maneuver out. Pure strength, got every limb intact, so the guy's got no way to protect himself. Now look at this, Duncan, high risk. Whoa, baby. That'll knock the wind out of anybody. There's this, their patented finish, 10 feet in the air. You've got world champions, WWF.
When we return, the guest of Paul Bearer in the Funeral Parlour will be the Ultimate Warrior.
I'm sure.
Well, we're back, and, not too happy about it. But nonetheless, you will recall Ben Franklin years ago said it. IRS just last week said it, that, there are only two certainties. One of them is paying taxes, and the other one, maybe this will give us a little idea.
Come in. The doors are always open just for you. If you remember last time, I told you that I issued a challenge to everyone in the World Wrestling Federation to pay a visit to my parlor. But no one accepted the invitation until today.
Can't help it when I look at him, I look at the end of my own career.
Welcome, Mr. Warrior, to my mortuary. I thought you would never
Wait a minute.
How do you like that, Mr. Ultimate Warrior? You will look so natural, so at rest, laying inside this casket. And by the way, we made it a double X, so it will accommodate your massive physique.
Look at this.
Oh, you little warriors, look at him. Look at his face. He's scared. The Ultimate Warrior is scared. Not only are you scared of death, Mr. Warrior, you, my friend, are scared to enter the ring with The Undertaker.
Well, you can't blame him for that.
Look at him, little warriors. He's scared. You're scared. I see it in your eyes. You're scared.
The bloodshot look in my eyes. Mr. Paul Bearer has been misinterpreted as the fear you know. But it only is the power possess even more. For WrestleMania 7, I question my destiny just for that one moment. And the God spoke to me and told me now was not the time to start that journey back to parts unknown. Now was not the time for my powers to cease. Now was not the time for me to be buried or covered by any sacred ground that you, Mr. Paul Bearer, or The Undertaker walk upon.
You might say that you're not scared, but you're going to be scared. Yes, yes, you're going to be scared. You are going to be scared.
I feel not the cold chills of this parlor. My warriors and myself fear not even death itself.
But look at your face. You're scared.
Wait a minute.
You're scared, and you're going to be
scared.
Wait
a minute.
You're going to be scared.
Like The Undertaker from behind.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
The Undertaker all over the warrior, attacking him from behind, hammering down the shoulder area, hammering in the back of the head. Oh, no, he picked up one of those metal urns. He just clobbered him in the back of the head. Look at this, driving him into the casket. The Undertaker, all over the Ultimate Warrior. What a cheap shot. What a setup. No, he's got an urn again for the back of the head.
Oh, spirit-loving war, Ultimate Warrior. What do you like? Yeah, I like it.
Wait a minute. The Undertaker just told Paul Bearer that they opened the casket.
Right there, he did it. Yeah, he did it. Right there.
Wait a minute, look at the crank.
He's cranking, he's locking it. Wait a second, man. How's he gonna breathe in there?
Wait a minute. They're not gonna.
He's got the key.
Okay, prove your point now. Where do we go from here? Huh?
Let him out. You got your point. He's beat up.
Let him out and beat him up some more is what I would do.
Somebody better get some help down there. As you brought out earlier, those things are airtight. They're watertight.
Hey, wait.
Get him out of there.
Where's the official? Wait a second.
All right, finally, we're getting some help over here. Yeah.
Thank you. God, this guy's been in there 30 seconds. You need to get him out now. Gorilla, pull.
Hey,
this is it. That's too long. That's too long.
They better get that key back. They better open up that coffin, and they better open it up fast.
Who's got the key?
Yeah, that's over. There we go.
We've got more help on the way, folks.
Thank heaven for that.
Yeah, but I'm getting the job done. I'm telling you, he's been in there a while now. I'm telling him.
Can you imagine what he's doing in there? Can you imagine he's trying to get out of there? Yes, you can hear him. All right, we got a crowbar.
All right, they're going to do
it. All right, get it, boys. That guy's been in there 45 seconds so far. That's airtight.
I've done a lot of things in my career gone past the danger zone, but this is something different, and they need to get him out of there, and they need to get him out of there now.
They can't get the cut. They can't get it open. Get that casket open.
Come on, man. It's almost a minute. Get him out of there. Don't drop that.
Dropped it right on top of the casket.
These guys are... Wait a minute. We got something else.
They're moving too slow.
I think they've got a chisel.
Okay. We don't need the call-off. We got some brain surgeons. Get him the hell out of there.
Trying to jam that.
Oh, they're opening it right there. It's going to get open right now. Come on.
You've got to break the seal on it.
This is not
my style. That's what you have to do in order to get the air in there. You've got to break the seal. You've got to get in there somehow. Give the man some air.
We're moving too slow.
Get the chisel down where they lost it. Right there. They don't know what happened. Okay, get the drill right in the air. Need hole.
Get an extension.
The Ultimate Warrior's got to be out by now. He's passed out in there. He has no air. Can you imagine trying to claw his way out of it?
I wash my hands of this right now.
We're talking a minute and 45 seconds he's been in there.
You can't even penetrate it with a drill. You can't. Come on, get in there. Get them out. Get the rescues. Get somebody in here to help this guy.
Somebody beat up Paul Bear and get the key back. Because what you need to do, you gotta get the key.
There. They're trying to drill some holes in to get some air into the casket.
This is getting ridiculous.
They're trying everything they possibly can do. Find out. There's a puncture there. They punctured. Maybe there's a little bit of air to get in there somehow.
Tell you, I can't stand this. I got claustrophobia, and I can't stand it. I just can't stand sitting here.
That ain't enough air to keep an ant alive. You have the 4-6 stooges down there.
Come on. Break in there. Come on. Get it open somehow.
You're going to be careful how they hit that casket right there.
Come on.
He's not even hitting the side of the casket that counts. Come on, you guys, dig in.
They're driving the chisel. They're driving the wedge in there. Hey, something's got to be done. Wait a minute.
Look at They got it.
All right.
They got it up.
Wait.
Oh, my God. Look,
look at that. Oh, no. Tried to claw his way out.
This is too much. I didn't expect this. I didn't expect this one time. I didn't know him. You know, that's the guy.
They're giving him.
I gotta get him going.
CPR.
Yeah.
Trying to get him going.
Just do it. You know, the end of my career, but not this. Not this way. I don't like it. It's wrong. It's not the way. It's not my way. It's not anybody's way. It's too much.
The mouth to mouth. They're giving him the CPR. Help is on its way. Professional help, I can tell you that. But when are they ever going to get here? When is the professional help ever going to get here?
It's already been too late.
He's stopped breathing.
I don't know if his leg's moving right there, if they're just pushing him hard.
They're just pushing him.
Wait a minute. He's coughing.
Okay, come on.
He's coughing. Yes. He's moving. He just moved his elbow and his arm.
Okay.
He's coming around.
That's better. That's better. I'm going for this right here because I want him out of there.
Ultimate Warrior.
Just raised his head.
Coffin. Yes. Oh, my God. What an ordeal.
I'll tell you, that's
never in the history of the World Wrestling Federation.
Look at the way he tried to claw his way out of that coffin.
See the top of the casket? Tried to claw his way out of it.
But it must have been a while ago because when they opened it, he wasn't clawed right there because he had quit clawing.
Well, get him out of there.
He's breathing on his own. They're trying to give him some air. Professional help is going to be here any second.
Yeah, they're going to be here any second, but they're already late as far as I'm concerned.
Bottom line. Well, they need to get him out of there and get him to some more air. Just give this man some room. Let him breathe on his own.
He was in there more than 5 minutes without air.
the amount of brain damage that that could do to a man. They need to get him down in the locker room and get some oxygen on him now.
I just can't imagine that the Undertaker and Paul Bearer would have done something like this, would have attacked from behind, the premeditation of it all. And Paul Bearer drawing him in closer and from behind, the Undertaker attacking, ramming the urn, the metal urn, in the back of the head of the Warrior repeatedly, semi-conscious, dumping him down into that horrible coffin. And imagine the lid slamming shut, and you're in the coffin, and it's coming down over you, and you breathe, you gasp your last breath of air. No one can imagine the feeling of that. No one.
Well, we're back with more World Wrestling Federation action, but it's the action back in the dressing room right now that we're most concerned with. The status, the condition, physical condition of the Ultimate Warrior.
I gotta know, man.
Unfortunately, we can't tell you a whole heck of a lot other than the professionals have arrived on the scene for some time, but nonetheless, they are here, and they're in the Ultimate Warrior's dressing room, and he's being attended to. So as soon as we get an update, we'll advise you of everything that we know. Right now in the ring, entering the ring, the tugboat, big mighty tugboat. But I would think it's even tough for the tugboat to get himself up for this match, considering what we saw just a few moments ago.
Well, he's going to have to. He's a professional. He's in the World Wrestling Federation. But I understand what you mean, Vince McMahon, because right now I'm not feeling really right because of the way that I talked right before the Ultimate Warrior came out. Because when I look at the Warrior, I can't help remembering WrestleMania 7. And even though I dislike him, nobody in the World Wrestling Federation deserves what he got.
Indeed, no one does. And you don't have too much to say. You must be...
I'll tell you, I got to think about it.
I'm at a loss for words myself, Roddy Piper.
I've never seen nothing like it before, and I think it's probably one of the worst things I've ever seen.
I think unquestionably it is the worst thing I've ever seen in the World Wrestling Federation. I just can't imagine what happened when... the beating is one thing. Coming up from behind a man, crashing a metal urn in the back of your head is one thing, but...
But putting a man in a box and sealing it where he can't breathe, and we're talking over 5 minutes, that's gone below the line, man.
The big thing that I see is they left the area. Paul Bearer and The Undertaker probably left the building not even knowing who got in, when, or what.
But now, Roddy Piper, I always like to try to put myself in another man's boots. What could the Warrior been thinking when... He got nailed from behind him. That's all fine. He got beat up. That's happened before. But he got put in the coffin. They started closing the door on the coffin. He tried to stop him. He couldn't. The coffin was shut. He breathes a little bit. All of a sudden, he starts to get dizzy. No air. He starts to scratch and claw and claw. And he pushes with all his might. Nothing moves. But the stale air, the stench. Can't move the arms. Can't move the leg. What was the last thought? As he was going down, as he was going unconscious, I can't imagine. Matter of fact, I can't take it no more. I gotta find out what's going on. Boys, I'm out of here.
And we're gonna be out of here in a moment as well. We're gonna take you now to Irwin R. Scheister, better known as IRS.
Hello, I'm Irwin R. Scheister with more of my 17 reasons why you should file your tax return on time. Reason 13, if you're late, I'll come after you. Reason 14, if I come after you, it'll be like the lying, cheating criminal that you are. Because to me, late filers are nothing more than con men trying to swindle the U.S. government. And the same goes for all of you who plan to claim more than 2% of your gross income as deductible. Or those who'll try to sneak a few business deductions through without fully itemized receipts. You can just forget about it. And forget about finding some kind of tax loophole, too. Because if I get wind you're trying to do that, I'll see to it that that loophole gets tightened right around your neck.
Don't wait until the last...
Superstars of Wrestling, scheduled to join us will be the Dragon. We'll also see the tag team of the Legion of Doom. And in the Funeral Parlour, the guest of Paul Bearer next week, Sergeant Slaughter. And then from there, the British Bulldog will be in the squared circle. And then, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, will join us next week. And we certainly will have an update on the Ultimate Warrior next week.
Man, I got enough. He's back there. He's shaking. He's sick to his stomach. His eyes is dilating. He's sweating one time. The next time, he ain't sweating. He's cold. He ain't speaking to nobody. He don't want nobody around. He tried to get up. The guy is in bad shape. He fell down.
Join us next week for more Superstars of Russia.